Well, we wondered how you followed the amazing action of the Winter Gardens last night. Now we know. You put Phil Taylor and John Lowe on the same stage and you get an absolutely epic encounter. And in the end, the current world champion has beaten the former world champion by 17 legs to 15. And I'll tell you what, Phil, you said to me...
Him first, I'm shattered.
Well, I sure won't work with you, because you said to me that you like to be pushed. Are you sure?
I tell you what, you know, somebody asked me today, he said, what are you going to do with that 100 grand you just won? Give it him and send him Australia and bog him off. Honest to God. He just don't give in, does he? You know, this is...
I think, John, you led on 6 different occasions. And you were 11-9 up at one stage and had a couple of darts at double top.
I think it was a couple of wrong darts, you know, a couple of wrong doubles, well, one wrong double, which could have made a big, big difference. And, well, you brought your mind's going up there. Come on, just play your game. I'm very lucky my hands don't sweat, and my ears don't sweat a lot either. So we're dead lucky that we can just stand up there and keep cool in this massive heat. And tonight, I honestly believe, I could beat him.
So did I. I did as well.
Did you think that before the match started, John?
Well, I've always thought that all my life. It's not if you give up before you start, then that's a waste of time playing the game, isn't it? You know. I respect the man unbelievably, the phenomenal way he plays. But I thought, well, maybe I can reduce his 180s down to 85s and 76s, and managed to do that a couple of times.
I mean, how exhausting was it up there, Phil? I mean, it was two heavyweight boxes together, wasn't it?
Oh, this has been one of the hardest weeks of my life, this has, honest to God. Kevin Painter, Chris Mason, and then Johnny. It's not Manchester United, seriously, I keep saying this. It's getting harder and harder and harder for me. He plays superbly, and that John Lowe can play twice as good as that. He played brilliant, and I'll tell you what, people don't realise how good this man is, do you know what I mean? It's nice to actually stand and watch him. When he's playing, when he's flowing, there's nobody in the world, I don't care who they are, would live with this fella. He's I don't know, I just don't know how he does it.
I'm sure he hates people talking about his age all the time, but will you still be playing the way he is when you're 57?
Are you 57? Are you? Oh, yeah.
What do you mean? I don't look it. Thank you very much.
I hope so. I mean, God almighty, he's a credit to everybody. I mean, the fellas, no world champion, ex-world champion, I don't care who they are, what sport it is, will get up perform the way he has. And I'll take my hat off to him, I'll take everything off to him, I'm going to take my underpants off and go upstairs. The fella is fantastic, he really is, and I can't sing enough praise for him.
I just know how much you hate to lose, Phil. Was that the difference in the end? Was that kept you going, even when all the doubles weren't going in as you'd liked?
I think if John had beat me tonight, I would have had a nice excuse and said, well, you know, the night had put me off forever, but I'll be quite honest with you, if I'd have got beat tonight, I wouldn't have felt a loser, you know what I mean? I played John a few years ago, and exactly the same, and I won, and I didn't feel as if I'd won, and also I didn't feel as if I'd lost. And that year there was two world champions, it was me and him, we clashed in the semi-final, but the fella is, well, Eric will tell you, Jockey will tell you, even Bobby George will tell you, the fella is brilliant, you know. When he's on form, there's nobody to live with him. They really can't.
Because you're having a new lease of life, aren't you, John? There's no question about it.
I'd like to think so. I just think that if you sow bad seeds, it'll come round and haunt you. And I don't think I've done too much wrong in my life at darts. You know, I'm only talking darts. And I think, honestly, when you get up there, I know the stage, I know the dartboard, I know the people I'm playing. If you're playing Phil, it's not going to throw in 45. You're going to lose, aren't you? Badly. You're going to get absolutely murdered. So the only way to beat Phil is, like, try and stay with him. And I was very fortunate tonight. I had something like massive support in that audience. I mean, and I wasn't going to tell them to be quiet, really. I did in one stage right near the last leg, but I wouldn't do that earlier because I thought...
Well, I saw you, when Phil was throwing the winning double, that you were trying to get the crowd to be quiet behind, which is fantastic sportsmanship.
Yeah, well,
that's proper, isn't it?
The fella's a gentleman, there's no two ways about it. And when he said the crowd was singing, I was singing for him at one time. And I remember the match against Martin Adams when I actually did sing on TV. That was the beginning of my record career, me and Robbie Williams, but it never came off. But But the fella, and I can't sing enough praises, not just for him, for Chris Mason as well, for Kevin Painter. Shane, unfortunately, didn't play as he can do, but this has been a very, very tough week for me, especially after the nine darter, and I thank everybody for the support. Ricky's been watching me tonight. I think Ricky's going to give me a few left hooks, and Anthony Farnell's up there now, and see, they can do it in one round, but I can't see.
It doesn't look, Phil, as if it would take much to floor you at the moment, to be absolutely honest.
I'm absolutely shattered, I'll be honest with you. He's took every train out of me. I'm knackered, if I can say that on TV. I'm absolutely shattered.
You've won the match and the search, so you can tell us you've both played terrific darts up there, but I mean, how unsettling was it to have had the nine darter yesterday and won the money?
The nine darts is a bonus, and you know, I woke up at like 1 o'clock this morning, I didn't get until 1 o'clock, but went to bed, woke up at 2 o'clock, woke up at 3 o'clock, and then I had to nudge Eve on us. I said, did I do a nine darter last night? She says, yeah. So I thought I was, I honestly dreamt it. I thought, please don't let it be a dream. Oh, you know, that was my dream ever, and I thought I've dreamt this. But she says, no, you've done it, and it wasn't so much off-putting. I wanted, if I could, I knew I'd got to play well against him. I could tell the way John was... See, certain players, you can tell how they are, and when John's relaxed and he's chatting away and he's doing his practicing and he's hitting the scores, you know, you look at him, you think, hello, here we go. This is going to be the toughie, this. And it was, and God bless him.
One of the toughest matches of your life, would you say?
I think that one and Eric's match, I mean, people say Mike Gregory, this, that and the other, I didn't feel as shattered as it was. This is absolutely exhausting me, I'll be honest with you. I'm absolutely shattered.
What's left in the tank then, Phil? Because you've got a final to play tomorrow now.
I'm going to send him up. He'll murder party tomorrow. Tomorrow's going to be a different day. I'm going to have a good, as you say, when you've been here all week and you've tried that hard to get to the final, I can relax now and enjoy it, you know. John's going to play well against me, I mean... Every time I play John so far, I've given John a good hiding, you know. But tomorrow can be a different story. John's going to come out. John's on a high. He wants to beat me bad, you know. So that's going to be my advantage. I hope John isn't too keen. Otherwise, he'll lose. And I think John's going. I think we're in for another. Well, I have not had an easy game yet, except for Shane. But it's going to be a good final tomorrow.
Well, it's been a fantastic week, John Lowe. Thanks very much for your contribution to it, which has been really significant. Phil, has Yvonne spent the money yet?
No, she bought a new shirt today, new tops and trousers, and no, not at all.
Fantastic.
I'm going to give it him and send him away.
What a week it's been. Absolutely astonishing. Congratulations to Phil Taylor and commiserations to John Lowe. It's been a wonderful night here. Let's just tell you what's happened here in Blackpool this evening. There's confirmation, John Part beating Colin Lloyd by 17 legs to 12, and Phil Taylor beating Johnny Lowe in a wonderful match by 17 legs to 15. Tomorrow, the final then, Phil Taylor against John Part, Sky Sports 2 at 7 o'clock. Looking forward to that. John Part looking very much the part against Colin Lloyd. Last night, of course, was the high point for Phil Taylor. Tonight, it looked as if it could be the low point, but then the current world champion came through against the former world champion in great style. Good night.
Wait for the light.